This is the fourth and final episode in our series of fitting a VW van to be powered remotely. In this episode, we're connecting the Colour Control GX to the system and to the Victron VRM portal. Plus, we will be showing you a full schematic drawing of the installation. One of the key components to monitor the lithium battery is the BMV 712 Smart Battery Monitor. With built-in Bluetooth, this monitor is recommended to be used when using Victron lithium batteries of the type used in this van install. There are only three items connected to an always-on circuit. These will remain live even when the rest of the system has been shut down if any of the lithium cells report a low voltage. The BMV 712 Smart Battery Monitor, the Colour Control GX, and the GX GSM modem. The BMV 712 has an extremely low current consumption of just 1 milliamp when the backlight is switched off. The Colour GX has a current consumption of 140 milliamps. The GX GSM modem has a current consumption of 210 milliamps when sending data and 109 milliamps when idling and GPS enabled. This totals to around 351 milliamps, worst case scenario. If this 200 amp hour lithium battery goes into a low cell voltage event, there's a capacity reserve of 2 amp hours left in it. This can power all three items for over 5.5 hours, more than enough time to take action. The battery monitor's shunt should be the only thing connected directly to the negative terminals. This is to ensure it can measure all the power taken from and back into the battery. You may notice a smart battery sense is also connected to the battery before the shunt. This is only connected as this is a demonstration van. The smart battery sense should not normally be included when using a VE BMS. The battery monitor has three connectors on the shunt. An RJ12 cable that goes to the battery monitor display, a fused positive to the B1 port. In this install, the engineers have connected the alternator battery positive via a fuse supply to the B2 port. This is so the monitor can also monitor the van's starter battery, which is connected to the alternator. On the battery monitor itself, there's the other end of the RJ12 cable and also a VE Direct to USB interface cable. This will send the battery information to the Colour Control GX. The Colour Control GX is the main communication hub in the system. Users can see exactly what is happening on the display. Both the Colour Control GX and the BMV battery monitor are installed in a wall mount enclosure. The engineers want the Colour Control GX to remain on, even in the event of a low lithium battery voltage event. This is so the unit can send alerts and engineers can monitor the system remotely and take action if required. The Colour Control GX is protected by a 1 amp slow blow fuse and connected to the lithium battery positive after the master fuse. Two VE Direct cables are connected to the rear sockets, one for each solar MPPT controller. The VE Direct to USB from the battery monitor is connected to one of the USB ports. A GX GSM modem has been connected in this van installation. It's a cellular modem providing a mobile internet for the system and a connection to Victron Remote Management System, or VRM. The modem is supplied with a small aerial which is screwed into the side of the unit. The engineers would also like to keep track of where the van is using GPS and the VRM website. They are using the optional active GPS antenna to track the location of the van using global positioning system. On the VRM portal, they can create a theoretical fence where the van is located. This is called a geofence. If the location of the van is sensed outside the fenced area, it can alert the user via email. This is a great security option, as well as an option to monitor the location of the van in general. The GPS unit has been connected to the modem side and a standard size active SIM has been inserted. The USB has been connected to the colour control GX, and finally the power connectors have been wired into the power in via the included fuse. When powering up, the blue LED will display as a solid light. Once it is registered on a network, it will start blinking slowly. Once it's established the internet connection, it will blink fast. Now it's time to set up the colour control GX. We will go through the settings used in this installation. There is so much you can do with the colour control GX, we advise you to check out the detailed manual online. We've included a link to this in the description below. We can use a combination of buttons under the screen to navigate our way around the screens. Using the right-hand top button, we enter the menu area. The first screen shows you the device list. This is a list of all the connected items. We need to navigate down to Settings, then either click right or the center button. Navigate down to System Setup and click the center button. As we have a shore power connection into the side of the van, we navigate to AC input 1 and choose shore power. Press the center button to confirm. Next, we need to navigate down to Has DC System and select it. This will now show a smaller DC power icon in the middle bottom section of the screen. If we hadn't turned that on, the system wouldn't report correctly, as there would be some power losses or gains. As we have the GX GSM device connected and the system is available to connect to the VRM portal, we need to enable this and connect. In Settings, navigate down the list to GSM Modem. Here you can see the status of the GSM modem network and if the system is connected to a transmitter, and also the current location of the GPS. There are lots of user guides and videos to help you create your VRM account and set the system up. Again, we've included links to those in the description below. For the benefit of this video, we are going to assume you have already set up your account. In Settings, navigate to Remote Console. Ensure Enable on VRM is selected. In the VRM portal page, you can set the log interval. Logging data can be sent to the VRM for as little as 1 minute to once a day. We have currently set the van to update the system once every minute. Lastly, we select Display and Language. In here, we can set the brightness of the screen, but we want to change how long it takes for the screen to deactivate. We change the setting to 10 minutes. As the colour control GX is part of the always-on system, by deactivating the screen, it will conserve more energy. This install has been a fun project for the Victron team here in Romania, and after a lot of tweaking and checking, this is the final wiring diagram the team have decided upon. You may see there are a few additions and tweaks to what has been shown in the episodes, mainly for extra safety and good practice. If you are planning on doing a similar van install, we suggest you contact your local Victron dealer for help and advice. A link to the schematic diagram is in the description below. We hope this series has been useful to you, and from all the team here in Romania, goodbye.